So this right here is Superlist, and it launched probably around a year ago, maybe even a little bit longer, and the application has evolved very much in the last couple of months. However, we're going to give you a recap of it, give you an overview to see whether Superlist is suitable for you. And of course, if you're interested in subscribing, you can find out Tool Finder below, which you can subscribe to. And if you're interested in getting the top ranked, not note-taking applications, to-do list applications, maybe you're looking around in the market for not just Superlist, but the other options, you can find it linked below as well. So welcome. My name is Francesco. We're going to dive straight into this. As you can see, this application has a beautiful today area. I can start adding tasks really easily. And what's nice about this system is it's very clean. You've got this lovely banner over on the right-hand side here, and it's very nice in terms of the offering. So for example, if I say create review on Superlist, I can add a task straight away. And obviously it will go down to the bottom here because I've got a range of different items already. Now, if I enter the task, you can see a bit more detail of the task. And I can add it to today, I can add it to myself, I can add a label if it's an errand, for example, and I can add subtasks. But the real power of Superlist is that every task you create or every list you create, it can be modified in a lot more detail. And this sort of makes it a pseudo note-taking application, and hence why I got a little bit confused at the start. But you can add markdown. So for example, here you could say introduction. I could do all my scripts in here, and I can use bullet points. I can use the slash command to create things like images, attachments, block quotes, dividers that come in a lovely squiggly fashion. Even if you add more dividers, there's a few ranges, which is quite nice. And I can use full markdown here to be able to write my notes. Now, what's nice about this is I can move this around. You think about the different opportunities you can have with this. For example, in here, you could start writing a few notes. You could add some subtasks. You could add some links that could be helpful to this goal or accomplishment. Now, there is a AI feature called Make, and Make essentially allows you to break down tasks. For example, top 10 tips for running a 5K. And the AI will use generative AI to essentially create this feature or this recommendation. You can see all of the subtasks that were created as part of that. So everything can be ticked off, say I did it, and it comes with beautiful sound animation as well, if that's something that you really like. And what I like about this experience is it's got integrations. Now, I will show the integrations, what limitations you have, but this is sort of like the task consolidation concept that I talked about a few months ago. So task consolidation, I won't bore you. Very simply, it's the ability to bring in tasks from other apps and consolidate them in one place. Think of like a dashboard where you can organize everything. And this is connected to Gmail, Google Calendar, and Microsoft To Do. So essentially, I can get my Gmail brought in here. I can see calendar events as well. And this is helpful for creating calendar events in Google Calendar for your tasks, so that you can see and basically time block, which is effective. You can also sync it with Microsoft To Do, which was formerly Wunderlist, which is who owned this company, or the creators of Wunderlist are the ones who started this company. So you've also got email forwarding as part of the free plan. This is great for email forwarding items in. And there's even an AI feature, which helps you to summarize that task, turn emails into actionable items. I love that. We've also got linear connected, but these are part of the pro experiences, Slack, GitHub, Figma as well. But you can connect up linear as well and automatically create an issue when a task is assigned to you. So the concept is really simple. You can see that these are those tasks that I need to get done. And you can see that I brought that item into my system from linear. So this is really nice in particular because for some people, they want to be able to micromanage the different elements of their day and have it in one place and actually start assigning time to them. But you can unsubscribe to it if you do want to, or disconnect it at any time. So I've shown you that today area in a very loose way, but in the today area, you can organize them based on a list, due date, create whatever you like, really. It's typical stuff that we see. But the real magic of this application comes in the list view. For example, in the list, it's sort of like not just a list, but a way to break down tasks, a way to break down ideas. And this is fully collaborative. So for example, if I wanted to invite other people to it, I can do it if I want to. So I can add images in here as well. For example, I could add an image like this, for example, and I can bring that in. And I can see people in real time when I'm working in here, which is really nice. I can break down tasks and continue them. I can even leave messages for colleagues or little voice notes if I want to as well. And at any given time, I can share this list to people that I'm working with. So that does lead me on to the abilities you have with Teams. For example, you can switch on and off certain things you're working on. And I like this because if I was like working on work only, I could switch to this mode. And if I was working on personal only, I can switch to this mode. So this is really nice in terms of how it breaks down stuff. It also uses some really nice backgrounds to get things going. You can also use the emojis here and some of the imagery as well you can bring in. They've got some lovely backgrounds here. This one was the old Wunderlist one, I believe. And you can see that you can customize. You can search on Unsplash as well if you did want to. I believe that's how I found that running one. But let's just jump to this one. So if I can create any tasks I can do, I can create any list from here. So lists can be used for anything. You can collaborate on a meeting agenda all the way to writing a list of the things you need to do as you go across the day. In terms of the core experiences, that's pretty much everything in terms of the offering. However, the pricing remains fairly reasonable. You can add unlimited tasks, unlimited functions like reminders and lists as part of the personal account, but there is a 5 team member limit on the teams, which is great because you're getting started. And some of the personal pro experiences actually give you access to those linear and other things like that. So here's what the lists look like. You can create a list at any time. It's really easy to do so. So if I just type new list, I can either add tasks or I could start making movies to watch, etc. And I could use tasks if I did want to. I can add tasks using Markdown as well. And I can assign them to other people. So if I wanted to watch The Covenant, then I can do that there. So you can start to see that this account, this experience works really well, and it just is a simple application at the moment. There's not, like, here are the stuff from other like emails and things like that, which is quite helpful. It's fast. Like, initially it had a few problems with sort of launching. You can see upcoming items, you can see done items, you can see items assigned to other people, and you can break stuff down with lists. This is really perfect if you're somebody that is very list orientated or checklist or want to collaborate with other people and want to be able to use a lightweight experience like this. The integrations are probably one of the stand-up features right now. If you compare it to something like Todoist, it's probably not quite there because it needs much more functionality. For example, you might need a board view, you might need a calendar view, more comprehensive than they've got, and you might need other functions as well. But I feel like it's heading in the right direction. I love the collaborative abilities. They're the standout things and the way they hide away as well. Obviously, this is something that you can really customize to your liking with these wallpapers and things like that. So you might just find it as a less intense or more casual way to manage your tasks than software like Todoist. So hopefully that gave you a great overview of Superlist. It's an application that is growing over time and has that note-taking element that you might like. So thank you very much. If you want to check out Superlist, you can find it linked below. We'll try and include some deals if we have any. And if you're in the hunt for to-do-list applications, there's that ranked list. Or you can jump over to toolfinder.co to explore more. Thank you very much, and I will talk to you all very soon and hope you find the best note-taking app. Sorry, the best to-do list/note-taking app for you. Thank you very much. Cheerio.